described by Indirect Patches hosting as prestigious Commonwealth site as his coronation. In a week long window, which the international media are allowed in, people are taking huge risks. What happens to them when the media and the head of the government have that gone? The true test of the government's true commitment to the Commonwealth values. Jonathan Miller, Channel 4 News, Colombo.
Lawyer, I spoke to John Cabigan while he knew a bit more about the timing section of the Chapter 15 yesterday.
Well, we have, as I reported, been followed just about everywhere we've gone, and there have been protests in some locations too, including outside our hotel. I should just show you this. This is the main national daily newspaper here, the Daily News. It's a statement paper, and as you can see, take any great pleasure in becoming part of the news story here, or indeed my team, but because there is an irony in all of this. The Queen has persistently reported so much about what is going on in Australia, not only at the end of the war, but since then about human rights, meaning that journalists are asking us questions. Take this opportunity to make sure that this government is at least asked to live up to the principles which it says it's committed to.
Jonathan, thank you very much.
Now, almost 2.5 million people face higher energy bills as EDF Energy became the latest of the big six firms to hike up its price. The energy sector daily came from a treat for customers as cash cap. This should stop squeezing consumers into super high prices. EDF's average increase of 3.9% is lower for most banks by other firms, but it's still significantly higher than the rate of inflation, which today tells its lowest level in Europe. This is correspondent Shimon Kennedy.
Another day, another rise in energy bills, this time from EDF, but there are strings attached. It's hiking bills by 3.9% next year, much lower than the other big energy companies. Only if government plays along. The move has sparked controversy though, not least because EDF's rivals have raised bills on average by more than 9%. So what's going on?
It's true that EDF's price increase isn't as big as those of its rivals, but it will only stick to that promise if the government agrees to remove certain green tariffs from the bill. In effect, EDF is trying to